Okay, everybody, I've gotten a little further on with this. Welcome to part 3. First thing I want to point out to you is, remember when I said that this goes to the top left in the video number 2? Well, it's as it laid, I found out, which puts it down here. After reading closer on the instruction manual, it says as it lays, put it in the bottom left. You have to look at the diagram real close. This hole actually belongs down here for the nose wheel steering rod to come through from the nose wheel steering servo. So anyway, it goes to show you that while you're checking these, reading these instructions, it's also best to look at the plans also and get a handle on what's going on. And our defense, or my defense, that is the top left is standing this way. It's laying down. That's the bottom right. Just depends on how you got it laid. So you have to have it laid exactly the way the plan shows to understand top left. And also depends on if you're looking at it from the front or back. So maybe they should have been a little clearer to explain what that hole was for, or told you to refer to the plans. So I'm letting you know now to refer to the plan. What we did after we got these two sides, or what I've done, is I got the two sides joined together. The next thing they had you do was put your forward servo tray in. So I've already glued that into place. They also had you glue in, this is light ply, they also had you glue in this hatch bolt down piece that goes in the front. It's got a hole in it that your screw's gonna go down when you get your hatch in. They also tell you to put the rear servo tray in, but they don't want you to glue it in at this point. It's not glued in. And what I did was I just used a rubber band and wrapped around here to hold it in place, because none of this was back here. Then next, what they have you do is, where this little cutout is here, they have you put a piece of 1/4-inch balsa along here and then along the back, and that seals up the rear of the fuselage. And this is actually your, they call it the hatch tongue at the rear of the fuselage. Other things that were done is two pieces of triangular stock were cut and epoxied in to the side of the fuselage. They were glued to the top of the hatch bolt down piece on the top that I mentioned earlier, and to the firewall. This gives your firewall some extra strength. Then what they did next is, that's triangle stock. Next, they had you take this 1/4-inch square stock and they had you measure it from the rear of this little flange here on your hatch bolt down piece to this center former here, and cut two of them to length to match in here. They had you lay, that's these pieces here that I've already glued on. What they did was, they had you lay this piece down. This is your hatch cover. They had you lay your fuselage on here and square it up real good. And then what you did was, you put these pieces in and glued them to the top of the hatch only. And make sure you don't get it stuck to the fuselage. It just sticks to the hatch only. And let those set up. Make sure it was nice and square. And then once it dried, you had a nice fit for the hatch. Those are just actually hatch retainers. So that's where I've gotten so far. We've got the hatch cover on. This rear planked here. Our firewall beefed up. And we've got this tray sitting in here loose right now. It hadn't told us to put those in. And it's got our forward servo tray that is glued in. So that's where we're at right now. And we're going to get ready to move on to another segment. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Okay, what they've got you doing now is going ahead and gluing in the rear servo tray. Fits in just like that. Rear servos go toward the rear of the aircraft. These are for your elevons. And what they want it done is 1.5 inches away from the bottom. They turn it upside down and you're exactly 1.5 inches down. What I've done is, I've already put some epoxy on there, but as I've done before, I'm just going to run a little bead along here of the CA glue. Okay, here's something I found out after I glued in the rear servo tray. They had told me to glue it 1.5 inches from the bottom. Well, in doing so, my servo, I've got a standard servo, and this goes back to test fitting things. I don't know why they said 1.5 inches. My servo arm was flush with the top of the fuselage cabin, which is going to have the hatch over it, which means any linkage could bind on the top of the hatch. So I broke this loose. Fortunately, I was able to get a clean break and get it cut through. It took me some time. And as you can see, I've lowered this to where I will have plenty of room for the servo arms to work, and I will also have plenty of room underneath the servo for clearance to the bottom of the fuselage. So what I'm going to do is set this up in here to the servo and show you that now there's plenty of room in there still for the servo to fit. This is a standard servo, standard Futaba type servo. So since I know that's going to work, what I'm going to do now is measure down and see. This is actually 1 inch down from the bottom. So I'd advise you, when you put this together and you put your servo trays in, to make sure that you get that servo tray mounted properly. I'm also concerned with the front servo hatch that I've already glued in, so I haven't even checked that yet. Okay, that's going to be fine, but the reason that's going to be fine is because there's a gap in here when you glue this front hatch in. You can either push it to the top of the split in this former, this doubler on the side, or you can put it to the bottom. Unfortunately, I put it to the bottom, which gave me some room. I don't know why I did that, but I did. So keep that in mind. Make sure your servos are going to work. It's going to work. It's a little tight, but this is for our throttle and our nose wheel. And I can actually hook my linkage to the underside of that horn. It looks like there's room for it there. So keep that in mind, that I am putting this rear servo tray in 1 inch above the bottom versus 1.5 inches. Okay, we're wrapping up the fuselage section here. Let me explain to you what I've done while I had the camera off. First thing I did was I created the tongue that holds this piece on, the hatch on. Actually, what I've done is I've glued a piece of 1/4 inch stock that I cut and measured to the bottom of the hatch. We've got those two pieces that we glued on earlier that helps support it here, and we're going to bolt it down in the front here to this piece. And what we've done is we put a piece of 1/4 inch balsa that fills this gap in here at the rear of the fuse, and then we put a tongue on here, just a little piece of light ply. It says to use a piece of scrap, and we glued that in place so that when we put this on, this will fit like so, nice and tight. Come down like so and set itself right in, and there you've got, and that'll bolt down and it won't go anywhere.